Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Fluctus Channel. There is one sound a fighter pilot would bide his time to react. It's none other than the siren for a scramble alert. Scrambling puts fighters in the air in a matter of minutes. A delay of a few minutes allows more room for a bandit to penetrate further. Scrambling efforts were initially exercised by the Royal Air Force during the Battle of Britain in 1940. With today's state-of-the-art fighters, wiping out a city is a one-minute task. So, to be safe, pilots are trained to scramble whenever a possible threat is looming over the horizon.
So the responsibility of this detachment is to ensure that at any given time, these jets are ready to go to basically defend the southeastern United States against any bad actors that might want to do harm to our country.
Scrambling is the process of expediting the takeoff to intercept a penetrating bogey through the air. Not all pilots and squadrons are capable of scrambling. Squadrons operating under the Aerospace Control Alert mission are enlisted to receive scramble commands from NORAD, or the North American Aerospace Defense Command. F-15 jets have been the key fighter of the Aerospace Control Alert, with a representation of more than 50% of the total asset. An F-15 can be scrambled within a 5-minute time frame, thanks to the exceptional combat readiness of the fighters and personnel. A scramble is a collective effort of pilots and all ground personnel, including crew chiefs, maintainers, and weapon loaders. During a scramble, the environment becomes dynamic and full of critical tasks. Years of training efforts are being tested during the process. As even the slightest mistake could retard the process or even cause damage to personnel and equipment. A blaring siren heard via the public address system is the first sign of a scramble. Pilots rush into the locker rooms to grab their flight gear and make their way directly to the aircraft parking stands. If the parking stands are too far, a van or a pickup truck takes the pilots to the jets. As the fighters are already in the mission-ready state, being refueled and loaded with weapons, maintainers prepare the jets in no time. Pilots hop in and prepare the jet for takeoff. From here onwards, the fighter is minutes away from taking off. Once pilots receive clearance along with other information, they start the engines and head to the runway. After being scrambled and taken off to the sky, pilots may have to engage or escort the intruder. On rare occasions, Pilots will receive a command to engage with the bandit to neutralize the threat. In such cases, the air combat maneuvering skills of the pilot and the aircraft will be tested. F-15 jets, as a key asset in aerospace control alert missions, are well known for a superior track record when it comes to dogfighting. A fighter pilot undergoing dogfight training with an F-15 should focus more on identifying the fighter. The jet aircraft is fitted with two powerful engines that deliver a collective thrust greater than 50,000 pounds, making it a capable fighter. Through training, pilots identify the peculiarities of the jet, such as turn rate, cornering abilities, thrust to weight ratio, and climb rate. A thorough understanding of the characteristics will assist a pilot in performing the basic fighter maneuvers to gain an advantageous position to engage against the opponent. Apart from maneuvering the jet, pilots should be trained on G tolerance. During a dogfight, the aircraft is pushed to its limits, and so does the pilot. An F-15 pilot performing tight maneuvers can experience G loads of up to 9 Gs. Hence, understanding the G loads is extremely important and helps pilots to avoid G lock or G-induced loss of consciousness. Above all, situational awareness dictates the success of a dogfight. A pilot with bad situational awareness inherits more possibility to be targeted by the bandit by being on the wrong bearing compared to the enemy. Apart from the offensive measures, a pilot is trained to take defensive actions when required. The F-15's advanced electronic warfare system offers several countermeasures, varying from conventional flares to state-of-the-art radar warning systems. There is more possibility for an interception to grow into a tense situation. The most recent incident was two Russian Su-27 fighters intercepted by an American B-52 when flying over the Black Sea in 2020. As the U.S. Air Force claimed, the B-52 was flying in international airspace when the two fighters intercepted. They have flown exceedingly close to the bomber at a coordinated altitude. Intercepting a commercial aircraft for any reason is more likely to end without major events. But a military aircraft of one nation or coalition intercepting one belonging to another nation is a concern that leaves room for a conflict. In most cases, the intruder may be intercepted and escorted until it clears off. Escorting an aircraft is not peculiar to a hostile situation only. Usually, fighters escort their bombers and VIP flights as a fleet. The word escort was redefined with the introduction of air superiority fighters, such as the F-15 Eagle and the F-22 Raptor. Unlike escorting an aircraft with side-by-side formations staying in close proximity, an F-15 can defend the assets like B-52 bombers staying very far from them. A B-52 bomber flying for a mission would fly for hours, exceeding the operational range of most fighters. But an F-15 fitted with two conformal fuel tanks with a total capacity of 1,500 U.S. gallons improved the fighter's range or loitering time. Unlike usual drop tanks, conformal tanks do not occupy hardpoints, leaving the F-15 to be loaded with the same ordnance to defend the bombers during the mission. The inability of bombers to fight against enemy fighters and their higher value lies behind the reason for escorting them during a mission. But what if an entire base is under attack? In such chaos, all the aircraft in a base should take off with immediate effect. Even a delay of just a few minutes could cost human lives and billion-dollar assets. The U.S. Air Force is pushing the limits in such dire situations by implementing a tactic named Minimal Interval Takeoff, or MITO. As the name suggests, an aircraft takes off within the lowest possible time during a minimum interval takeoff scenario. An entire group of aircraft elephant walking through the taxiway to the holding point allows rapid takeoffs, one after the other. The B-52 Stratofortress is well known for scrambling and taking off with minimum intervals. A B-52 at full power during takeoff creates a strong wake vortex from its lengthy 185-foot wing. Pilots and other personnel undergo MITO exercises to prove their readiness for real-world emergencies. Usually, a MITO exercise is always combined with a scrambling exercise. To take airmen through the complete process from warning to takeoff. Taking a B-52 into the sky is an hour-long process. But during an emergency, U.S. airmen take a shortcut by starting the engines extremely fast with a controlled explosive cartridge placed within two of the eight engines. The cartridge explodes and creates a higher volume of air within the compressor, providing initial cranking power. Cartridge start chops the preparation time to just 10 minutes, helping the birds to get airborne at a moment's notice.
Biggest thing we're doing today is just showcasing deterrence to any adversaries or even our allies, basically reassuring them. Part of our mission is we can't always show exactly what we do realistically just because of the destruction we do cause. So this is just one way for us to showcase our deterrence capability basically at the MITO takeoff.
At the end of the day, it's all about how secure the nation's airspace is. Successful execution of scrambles and minimum interval takeoffs under a real-world threat will be the end result of all efforts taken over the years. That's the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss any of our new content. See you next time.